Hey everyone, and welcome to Rufus and Doofus. Just wanted to say my name is Chico, and I'll be your host throughout these videos. And if you saw my introduction, that was basically the first video that I did regarding this channel. Well, little update. I know I got the same shirt on, but there's so much to talk about, and I wanted to split it up into different videos. It is the same day, by the way. It's not like I'm wearing this thing forever. So where am I? I've been looking at a lot of RVs on Craigslist and any place I can find them, trying to decide what I want to get, what kind of an RV. If you aren't familiar with the types, there's a Class B, which is nothing more than a van. Very tight quarters, not very good to live in full time, at least not in my opinion. Then there's a Class C, which is, you've probably seen them around. They're mounted on a truck chassis. Usually there's a portion of it where there's a little sleeping area that hangs over the top of the cab of the truck. And then there's Class A's, and Class A's are the Cadillac of the motorhomes. When I first started this adventure, I thought I was going to go with a Class C. But the more I looked and the more I started to understand, I found that for me, I think a Class A is better. There's a lot more room in them. They are more livable than I would consider a Class C to be. So I guess I've made up my decision. If you have any questions about the Class B, C, or A, not that I'm an expert, but I can tell you what drove me towards my decision. So as I said, I've been looking frantically for an RV. At the moment, finances won't allow a purchase, but I do have some items that are going to be sold because of this move. And I hope to finance the purchase of the RV with those monies from the sales. One of the things I'm going to be selling is my Harley Davidson, which I'm going to break my heart, but I've been riding for a long time, so this is another change in life. And I have to make some sacrifices to achieve the benefits of what I want to do. So that's enough on looking for a Class A, or making the decision that I want a Class A, but now looking for it. I found numerous Class A's, and a lot of them are very, very beautiful motorhomes. The prices range from very cheap, for whatever reason, damage of some sort, age, usage, which hasn't been, you know, great or poor maintenance, to very expensive, which are brand new or, you know, almost brand new, and they can run way up over $100,000, and I'm nowhere near that price range. I found from looking at the ads and making a few phone calls that the things you have to really watch out for are mileage to some extent, depends on the way it was treated, but specifically leaks. If the vehicle had any leaks, that can cause a lot of problems, and that's what I'm learning so far. So at this point, we're looking to sell some things, accumulate a little cash, find a nice Class A that we can afford, and then we're going to go take a peek at it, and hopefully get this show on the road, you might say. Now, I'm going to try and make these videos with not too much chin music, you know, because everybody has a tendency to get diarrhea of the mouth, and I don't want to do that. But it's sometimes you can't help it. So that's it for today, and I just wanted to share that with you about the choice I made. And I guess that's step one in the process now. Well, actually, step one was making the decision. Step two is getting there. And I'll tell you, I have gotten rid of more crap. Obviously, you know, I'm going to be living with limited space, so you have to be conscious of weight. You don't want too much weight in there. The vehicle can only handle so much weight, and if you overload it, it can be dangerous, and we don't want to do that. So getting rid of clutter can be difficult. Yes, it can. I found that sometimes you're more attached to things than you should be. But once you get rid of them, it's amazing how you feel good. It's like this weight off your shoulders, And if you haven't used it in a while, you really don't miss it. So that's it. Sorry I had to throw that in there. So hope you enjoyed the video, and stay tuned, because we're going to make this trip work. Take care.